Do you ever feel like you want to eat the kitchen sink, especially when you're under stress? You are not alone. The trouble is when you're stress eating is oftentimes the food they eat is not going to be supportive to, help reduce that stress at all. And the other thing is when you're really stressed, what happens is your cortisol levels go through the ceiling, and that cortisol is that belly fat storing hormone. So if you're trying to lose belly fat, it makes it even more difficult. I'm Shauna Kay, female fat loss expert and author of this book, Lose Your Menopause Belly. And today what I want to give you is I want to give you 10 stress-reducing foods or cortisol-reducing foods so that when you eat these foods, it does help you help your body reduce stress so that it makes it easier to lose your belly fat. So I've got 10 foods for you. So the first food that I want to talk about is asparagus. Now, asparagus is high in folate, and when you eat folate, that helps to reduce high stress levels. Now, the next food that I have for you is avocados. And avocados is actually a fruit, and it's anti-aging. It's a good, healthy fat in avocado, and it actually aids in the reduction of storage of the unhealthy fats that you might have in your diet. So, avocados is a great thing to include in your diet. Thank you for the likes and the loves, and please share with anyone that you know is going on that has a lot of stress, under a lot of stress, because increasing the foods that I'm going to tell you in your everyday diet, whether you're under stress or not, is going to help to reduce those cortisol levels and help with trying to lose that belly fat. Because I have so many clients that try to reduce belly fat, but when you are under a lot of stress, it makes it really tough. Okay, so we had asparagus, we had avocado. All right, we've got blueberries here. So blueberries and all berries, in fact, are high in vitamin C. They help to reduce blood pressure. They're also a low glycemic fruit, so you're not going to get a ton of you're not going to get an insulin spike, and you cannot lose belly fat or any kind of fat in the presence of insulin. So you want to make sure that you're eating low glycemic foods, and berries are a great choice. All right, nuts. So you want to go nuts for nuts, but remember that nuts are very calorie dense. So a handful is all you need, especially if you're trying to reduce fat. Now, these are healthy fats and they're full of zinc, and zinc helps with depression and anxiety. So nuts are a good thing to include in your diet, but you must remember that they are calorie dense, so a little bit goes a long way. Now, chamomile tea, you might have heard, is great for sleeping. It's proven to be an anxiety reducer. So you can include chamomile tea, especially before bed. For my clients that have nighttime eating issues, I suggest a nice cup of tea before bed. It helps to hydrate you. There's no caffeine in it. It's going to help you with sleep and with stress reduction. Now, garlic not only will keep the vampires away, but it increases immune function, and it's going to be a natural stress reducer. Now, I didn't have any fish, but I use this to remind me about fish. Cold water fish in particular is great for increasing omega-3s, and also if you have oysters, that also increases zinc, which helps to reduce anxiety and depression. I didn't have a cow either, so I have this mug to remind me that grass-fed beef is a great way to reduce stress because it has more omega-3s, it has more vitamin C and E than grain-fed beef. Also, you'll not only increase your omega-3s, but you'll actively decrease your omega-6s when you have grass-fed beef, because omega-6 is associated to a host of inflammatory disorders. So we want to have lots of omega-3s and not so many omega-6s. So grass-fed beef is a great one for that. Green tea is a great stress reducer. It's considered a brain stimulant to help you stay alertness, but it is a very calming tea. So green tea is a great choice. And I did save the best for last. I think that's 10. I think I covered them all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I got them all, I think. Chocolate. Yes, dark chocolate does have antioxidants. You want to keep portion control in mind, and so little squares like this are great. Or if you do get a bar of dark chocolate, it might be a good idea to portion it out so that you don't get stressed over eating too much chocolate. But yes, it is known to lower blood pressure and have good healthy antioxidants in it that can help you take you to your happy place and reduce stress, reduce those cortisol levels. So those are 10 foods. I'm going to go through them quickly again. Asparagus, not in any order. And by the way, I didn't mention these in any order. Asparagus, garlic, chamomile tea, green tea, grass-fed beef, this to represent the beef, cold water fish and oysters for the zinc, avocados, berries, I've got blueberries here, and some nuts. And of course, we've got the dark chocolate as well that helps to reduce stress. These are cortisol-reducing foods, so when you include them in your everyday diet, they will help to moderate those cortisol levels. When you moderate the cortisol levels, it helps to help you reduce that belly fat. When you include it along with, you know, taking care of stress levels, increasing your quality of sleep, making sure you've got some good, healthy, sweaty exercise. You don't have to get a ton of exercise in. Like, you don't have to have hours, just short bursts of exercise. All those small efforts are going to help you reduce the cortisol and help you reduce belly fat. If you want some more great tips, you can go to, I'm going to put a link for my free book, Lose Your Menopause Belly. Thank you for the likes and the loves over there. I see lots of people have joined, but I don't have my glasses on, so I can't really read it. I'm kind of going live from a couple different spots, so thank you to everybody that has joined me. Check my link for free book, Lose Your Menopause Belly. It's all written up because I've got notes all over in this book that I often refer to. It's an easy read, but lots of great hacks so that you can look and feel your best. Thank you for joining me, and if you have any comments or questions, please put them. DM me on Instagram, put them in the comments. I will make sure that I address your questions. Love to help you. We will see you next time.